Hi guys, René here for GNS Threevolt. I want to show you how you can solve the RIP unicast lab. So this is how you can make RIP version 2 use unicast instead of multicast, which is used by default. So what are we going to do? Just two routers, set up V2 and then make sure it is unicasting. And I'm just going to advertise everything. There we go. Let's do a debug here. So we can see what is going on here. And here we go. Okay, so you can see sending V2 update to 224.009 to the loopback. Sending V2 to 224.009 on the fast Ethernet. Okay, so what I want to do is enable unicast for the fast Ethernet link. And what I'm going to do before that is I'm going to do a passive interface on the loopback. Because otherwise you get to see these messages, like I'm sending an update to the loopback and I'm receiving an update from the loopback. So it's like your router is a bit paranoid. So let's make it shut up. So by doing passive interface, it's not going to send RIP updates to the loopback. And after that, we need to make sure we configure the neighbor. So we configure the neighbor ourselves, and that will make it use unicast. So let's make some space and look at the debug here. And yeah, we have to be patient with RIP, it's not that fast. Okay, so this is interesting. Okay, so what do we see? Sending V2 update to 224, the multicast on fast Ethernet, and sending an update to this particular IP address. So even though I typed in neighbor, it's doing unicast and multicast at the same time. So if you want to block multicast traffic, you have to use the passive interface command for the fast Ethernet link. And you have to be aware of this, because this is one of those things that you might see at your CCIE. They ask you a question like, okay, make sure that RIP version 2 only does unicast. And when they state a question like that, it means that you shouldn't be using multicast or broadcast. So make sure that besides configuring the neighbor, you also have to do a passive interface command. Okay, this is looking better to me. So you can see sending V2 update to the unicast IP address and receiving. And I don't see any more multicast stuff going on. So that's it. This is how you do it. This is how you make sure RIP version 2 will only use unicast. I hope you enjoyed this. Thanks for watching and I'll see you next time.